Live from Hickory, it's Country-ish. Alan!
Get the country boy, and he's making it good. He was Jaws' underdog, resting Beaver Rawls, living next to the wood. He liked to eat the sushi, but he don't even fish. Not so much a country boy, it's more like he's country-ish. Moved out of Hickory and headed for Southern Cal. Wound up in TV and film, making Popsicle proud. Now this country boy is back with his family. Got himself a podcast, he knows it'll last, cause he's in Hickory.
Hey, that's right. I am from Hickory, and I'm happy about it. I hope you're happy, no matter where you are. If not, let me try and change that for you, huh? For the next hour or so, I'm going to work on turning that frown upside down. What do you think of that? It's Tuesday, bumpkins. It's Tuesday, December 21st, 2021, and this is episode 108 of Country-ish. And we have a very merry, holly, jolly, festive show for you today. We got a full house. The whole crew is here. You know what I'm saying? And we're playing Secret Santa Goodwill Hunting style. I'm giving money away. I got more residual checks. Someone's going to win money in this episode. Will it be you? Also, Bette Midler's trending. We'll talk about that. And Intern Isaiah is going to review the new Sex and the City show just like that. And small town news, Rudolph was attacked. Anyway, it's a great show. Stay tuned. We are live right now on Facebook and YouTube. And we're checking your comments. Well, you know, I'm not doing it. I got two interns over here. Look at this. Oh, they're all dressed up. We got Elliot the intern and Intern Isaiah. One of them's doing YouTube. One of them's doing Facebook. You guys leave a comment. I'll try and get to it. In fact, I'll ask you a question and answer it in the comment section. Maybe we'll get to it. Do you put Christmas decorations up in your yard? I want to know about it. What are they? Write it down there in the comments section. I don't always get to them, but what I do is I read the ones from last week. That way you know I'm actually doing this. So these are some comments from last week. Brian Doss, he said, you'll have to do the watermelon crawl if you're a small town mayor. Now, what do y'all know about the watermelon crawl? That was a song, wasn't it?
Yeah, it's a song from a country song from like the late 90s.
Yeah, yeah. So I am still running for mayor. They keep pushing the date back on that. So, you know, now I'm hearing it's May, possibly. They pushed it to May.
Yeah, the election's going to be in May now.
So, don't worry. I'm still doing what I got to do to throw my hat in the ring, and I'll keep you updated on that as it goes. All right. Roseanne Henshaw. Roseanne Henshaw. She said, need to change the answering machine. Instead of not recording, it should say not taking callers at this time. Try again later. You should only use not recording when you're not live. Thank you, Roseanne Henshaw. The Alan Jackson, will you please get on that for Miss Roseanne Henshaw?
I'll take care of that right away.
Okay. Well, Roseanne, I think it's just some sort of service that we use. We don't record it. It just comes with it. Am I right, The Alan Jackson? You don't have the ability to change that, do you?
It's complicated. But yeah. We're all good.
Right. We're on it, Roseanne. Thank you very much. Brian Corley. Last week I talked about Botox. There were some camels getting Botox. We talked about that. And Brian Corley said he gets Botox for TBI, 32 shots every 3 months. You know what TBI is, guys?
Traumatic brain injury,
wow,
I think.
Oh, I swear I was looking right at y'all. Good, that's right. It's traumatic
brain
injury.
Well, I Googled it last week when he commented. Right.
Dude, this guy's on top of it. Thank you, Isaiah. Yes. So apparently Brian Corley, I want to know what happened to you, buddy. What was your traumatic brain injury? I hope you're doing okay. And thanks for leaving a comment. And I'm going to read one on YouTube because normally I just read the ones on Facebook. But here's one that was left on YouTube because I said we're live on Facebook and YouTube. Hang on. Too many sausage balls. Mama makes good sausage balls. On YouTube, Jeremy P., he said, how is this not getting more views? Love you, Reep, and keep up the great work. Can't count how many times you've had tears coming out as I was laughing so hard. That's a good point, Jeremy P. One thing you can do to change that is hit the share button. That's what we tried to do at the beginning of the show. You saw that we were trying to get you to hit that share button. Go ahead and do it. You know what I'm saying? That's one way you can help. Also, real quick, what's up, Novel? How you doing? I'll be there in a little bit. Just kidding. But I do love Novel in Newton. Great place. If you're watching this, hit the share button. Look, I know when people are watching this, they're like, well, John, if I hit the share button now, I'm going to miss a funny thing that you do with your face. You know, it's like, and I don't want to take the time to look down here when I'm trying to see what you're doing up there. So I've come up with this thing. What I do is I put on this here share wig, and I come up with a thing called the share stare. It's where I look right down at the camera and I beg you to share. Do you believe in sharing the love? Huh? Come on now. I can feel something on top of my head. It's a dumb wig, is this not enough? Huh? Hit the share button, man. Look how hard I'm working for you guys. I hope you did it. If not, I hope you'll get around to it eventually. You know, you could hit the share button anytime. All right, let's move on. Real quick, I'm wearing this is my Scott Farkas hat for Christmas. We're also a podcast for your ear holes. Apple Podcast, Spotify, Pandora, iHeartRadio, Stitcher, Podbean, you name it, we're on it. Let me plug some tour dates real quick. Real quick, I'm going to plug some tour dates. The Ellen Jackson, I'm throwing you a curve. Oh, here we go. My next gig... You know, I'm off for Christmas. My next gig's going to be in San Diego, La Jolla, California, at the Comedy Store. I'll be there New Year's Eve all the way to January 2. Then after that, I'll be in Omaha, Nebraska, at the Funny Bone. Wahala with Reno Collier, and Shelby, North Carolina, with Reno Collier, the 29th of January. Check out tour dates at countryish.com. Look, I gotta introduce the guys sitting across from me at this table. We got a full house, man. I'm very honored to have both of these gentlemen joining me today at a very small desk. They're sharing a microphone, so we'll take turns. I'll go with the guy closest to me, actually. Sitting right here next to me is a very tall man. Comes in around 7 feet, 13 inches tall. Played a little b-ball for the Charlotte Hornets back in the day during the Kelly Trepuka years. Some people call him the fly swatter. Some people call him Sebastian. I like to call him the Southeastern Man of Mastery. How you doing, Sebastian?
I'm fantastic.
Good
fantastic.
To see you. I like the outfit.
Thank you.
What's the that's a cat.
It's my kitty.
You got a kitty down here, and is this whole thing like the cat's hair?
Cat's hair.
Okay.
Cat's hair.
I like it.
You want to pet it?
Not right now, but okay. I appreciate the offer. I'll take you up on it later, maybe. Okay. And I like the hat. Let's get lit.
The light.
Yeah, he's got little lights in there. Good to see you, and sitting right next to him, this good-looking elf right here. I'm telling you what, he's kind of famous. Well, his brother is very famous, which makes him kind of famous. You ever heard of Jon Stamos? I got his little brother, Marcus Stamos, sitting right here. What's up, babe?
Hey, Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. Happy Holidays.
It's Merry Christmas.
I know, but there's also a song called Happy Holidays.
Yeah,
but I like Merry Christmas.
A lot of people say Happy Holidays, but it's Merry Christmas around here.
I agree. Right. Merry Christmas,
Merry
everybody.
Merry Christmas, everybody.
Yeah. Good to see you guys. What'd you do this past weekend? I was in Lexington, Kentucky. Did you do anything fun?
I was in Florida.
Oh, you went to Florida?
Florida.
How's the weather down there?
Fantastic. 82 degrees on the beach.
I think Florida's got the highest case of Omicron right now.
We don't even acknowledge it in Florida.
Yeah. Well, good to have you here. I was in Lexington, Kentucky. Comedy off Broadway. That went great. If you were at my shows in Lexington, Kentucky, this is what I was talking about. Remember I told you about my podcast? This is it. And I'm glad you joined me. We packed the house. Here's me on stage. There's Brent Blakeney on stage at Comedy Off Broadway. We had a good old time. There's us in the green room. That guy, that's the house MC, the old guy to the right there named Scott. He's been there forever. Good guy, very funny dude. Me on stage once again. And then the hallway, they sign, all the comedians sign the walls. So I thought that'd be a good pick. Me and Brent Blakeney had a good time. While I was there, I noticed, you know, this is a trend that's going around right now. I'm starting to notice something happening with people, how they're dressing. And it's because of a TV show that you love called Yellowstone. I just started watching it. I'm addicted to it. I love it. But I'm noticing people are starting to dress up like the characters from Yellowstone. Not like I'm Kevin Costner, but they're all wearing the vests and the shirts and the, you know.
Yeah, everybody's a cowboy now.
The belt buckles, yeah. And the jeans that are ironed with the pleat on the front.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Like the crease in the front. Like I'm seeing a lot of that happening these days. I think it's because of Yellowstone.
Yeah, it's been becoming a very popular show.
Yeah. So there's this one table, this whole family. I looked right at them during the show. I was like, I'm a big fan of y'all. I love what you do. And they kind of embarrassed because they're like, yeah, we watch that show. We love it. So I kind of called them out a little bit. Yeah. Also, yesterday was Popsicle's birthday. My dad turned 77. And I went on the Twitters and my Facebook page and I said, hey, anybody that makes a video wishing my dad happy birthday, I'll play it. So I'm a man of my word. Let's play some of these, the Alan Jackson. Here's what you guys left.
How y'all doing on this Monday afternoon? We're here today, Mr. David, it's your 77th birthday. So we wanted to tell you from all of us here at Red Rum Motorsports, happy birthday, sir. We hope you have a great one.
Red Rum? Red Rum?
Red Rum.
Oh, here we go. Look at that. Santa Claus.
Look at that beard.
Oh, it's backwards.
Oh.
Happy birthday, Popsicle. I think he meant to turn it around. That's okay. I like the effort, sir. Thank you very much.
Happy birthday. I hope your day is a great one. I'm out here trying to get Bambi. Have a great day. Have a great birthday.
I guess he had to be quiet because he's looking for deer. Oh.
Happy birthday.
Oh, Marilyn.
Mystery.
Oh, wow.
Happy birthday, Mr. Reep. Happy birthday, Mr. Reep.
Okay.
Happy birthday to you.
Well, thank you very much, yeah. Marilyn Monroe.
Happy 77th, sweetheart.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, dear Popsicle. Happy birthday to you. Happy 77th birthday.
Oh, that was nice.
From Gabby's grandchildren.
That's Gabby. She used to be my babysitter at Busy Beaver Daycare when I was a kid.
Busy Beaver.
Popsicle.
That was the real name of it. Those are her grandkids right there. Wishing old Popsicle happy birthday.
Happy birthday to the man, the myth, the legend, the Popsicle. I couldn't think of a better person to share a birthday with. Today is also my birthday. Happy birthday, brother. Merry Christmas, and I hope your holiday is amazing.
Well, thank you, buddy. Oh, another Marilyn Monroe.
Oh.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, Popsicle. Happy birthday to you.
Okay, I think that was the same lady that did that. Oh.
Mr. Popsicle, I hope that you have a wonderful birthday. Hope that you eat plenty of cake and get all sorts of good sweets in your belly.
Yeah.
But I got a little song for you.
Oh, here we go. It
goes a little like this.
Me.
Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Okay.
Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Yeah.
I hope that you have a great birthday. Dun, 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 dun. Happy birthday. Happy birthday.
Wow.
Happy birthday, birthday to you.
Hey.
Happy birthday.
Yeah.
Hey.
Yeah.
I hope that you have a great birthday.
Thank you, officer. All right.
Yeah. Happy birthday, Popsicle.
Oh, that was good. Oh, yeah. Lee Lee.
Papa Reep, Popsicles. Happy birthday.
This guy was on Eastbound and Down with me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birday. Happy birthday, sir. Today.
You should.
Make it a great one. Enjoy your day. Much love.
You could do it.
Beats.
Oh, this is David.
Sing it.
from the cruise.
David Marino
from the cruise. This was his dad before he passed away, singing happy birthday. Feliz cumpleaños. That's Spanish for happy birthday.
Oh, instead of Navidad.
Right. Yeah. So thank you all for leaving my popsicle a happy birthday message. That made him very happy. He enjoyed it, so thank you for that. Also, I just want to say that I am my prediction of the Carolina Panthers and Cam Newton's return continues to be accurate. Here's a statistic for you. Panthers lost again. This loss drops since yelling, "I'm back!" In four starts, he's 0-4. The Panthers are 0-12, and Cam Newton's last 12 starts, he's thrown three touchdowns, four interceptions, and 5.6 yards per average or per attempt. He's 29th among qualified quarterbacks in that span. So he's back, everybody.
I thought there was only 28 teams. Does that mean he's 29th?
I think this is in over that span. I don't know if that means – I don't know. I'm just reading this.
And it's 32 teams.
Oh, I apologize.
There you go. See, I didn't – I just trusted you. All right.
Tama County.
Did you watch the game?
Yeah, I did.
Yeah.
Well, some of it.
Did you see our kicker – our kicker got hurt, our field goal kicker,
that's why
practicing.
Yeah, that's why we lost.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, that's what it was. We had to go for it on fourth down every time.
Yeah.
Or punt it. All right, well, let's move on to our first segment. We got a lot of show for you today. Don't forget, money. Someone's going to get money. Great news story. Christmas gifts are going to happen. Stick around. You're going to want to watch the whole show. This next segment has a sponsor. It's brought to you by Hendrick Honda Hickory. That's right. I'm loving my new Honda. I drive it all the time. Just drove it to Lexington, Kentucky, and back. Love it. Are you in the mood or the, not the mood or market or mood for a new vehicle? Go to Hickory Hendrick Honda Hickory. Get yourself a Honda, hot dog, and a hamburger. All right. Well, here's what's trending, guys. Hashtag Bette Midler. Woo, she's in the news. She wrote a tweet and got some heat from her tweet. It was a heated tweet. She said, what hashtag Joe Manchin. I love that name, by the way, Manchin. It's like he lives in a huge Biltmore house. Yeah. You know what I mean? Like the last name, I know it's spelled different, but when you hear the word Manchin, you think, oh, this is like, this guy's got, he's loaded. What Joe Manchin, who represents a population smaller than Brooklyn, has done to the rest of America, who wants to move forward, not backward, like his state, is horrible. He sold us out. He wants us all to be just like his state, West Virginia. Poor, illiterate, and strung out. So she got some heat for dissing West Virginia. And I know this to be true because I have bits, comedy bits about West Virginia. And they don't like being made fun of. Only West Virginia can make fun of West Virginia and get away with it successfully. You know what I'm saying?
Is that true, Isaiah?
I'm not from West Virginia.
He's from Virginia. He's from the western part of Virginia.
I'm from the
which
south
is like West Virginia.
Virginia.
It's Virginia, but it's West Virginia.
I'm sorry.
Not the state of West Virginia.
I thought
Virginia.
They kidnapped you and took you to West Virginia.
Yeah, what were your thoughts on this, guys?
The whites of West Virginia would probably love to get a hold of her right now.
Mm-hmm.
The wonderful whites of West Virginia.
That's right. Jessica would have a time with Bette Midler.
And is she blonde now? She used to be redheaded. Did she throw away her gingerness?
You know what? I think it's like any female. They just change their hair anytime they feel like it.
I can't trust her.
Yeah. I mean, let's see here. What do you know her from? You know her from Winds Beneath... What?
Beaches.
Beaches. What did you say the first time?
Beaches. The first
Beaches.
Time I think it was Beaches.
Beaches. She was in the movie Beaches. Something with witches.
Hocus pocus.
Wind beneath my wings. So, yeah, I know you can't mess with West Virginia because the only death threat I've ever gotten in my life was because I made fun of West Virginia. Guy left an angry voicemail and sent it to my Facebook Messenger.
Oh.
And he's cussing up a storm. And you could tell, like, he was very upset. And then I won him over. I was like, sorry, man, I was just joking around. where are you at? He's like, Charleston. I was like, oh, cool. I go to Charleston all the time. He's like, well, next time you come. You know, like, he's like already my friend.
After he threatened death, he wanted to be your friend.
But, yeah. You know, I feel like it's like a the whole sibling rule. Only a brother can pick on a brother. You know what I mean? Like, if me and my brother are hanging out and I see someone pushing my brother around, I have to go defend my brother. Although, when I was younger, I can't do it now because my brother's bigger than me. I'm the only one who's allowed to pick on my brother. You know what I'm saying? It's like it's like a family thing. So, she apologized. So she had to backtrack. She said, "I apologize to the good people of West Virginia for my last outburst. I'm just seeing red. Joe Manchin and his whole family are a criminal enterprise." Well, I don't know about that. That seems a little hocus pocusy to me. Is he really the best West Virginia has to offer its own citizens? I don't know. Surely there's someone there who has the state's interest at heart, not his own. And I really don't know exactly what's going on. I know that he basically blocked some bill from going through, you know, the whole, the Build Back Better thing. He's the only Democrat not to sort of sign on for that. So they're all giving him a hard time for that. And that's really all I know. So there you go, Bette Midler. Don't pick on West Virginia. Right, Isaiah?
Hey, I can pick on West Virginia.
Yeah, you can. All right. Also, hashtag, did you know today is Yule Day? What do you know about Yule?
It's a log.
Well, there's a Yule log. I've heard
Yule
that
Yule Tide.
Yule Tide.
You'll know when it's Christmas.
What?
Is that it, too?
Yeah. Well, it's Yule. On the arrival of the winter solstice, we observe Yule.
Yeah. Which is today.
Yes, today. Also known as Yule. Yule predates the Christmas holiday by thousands of years. Linguists debate the origin of the word Yule. Some suggest the word is derived from Lule, the Anglo-Saxon word for wheel. This makes a connection to the Celtic calendar, the wheel of the year. However, in the Norse culture, Yule refers to the god Odin. Odin was celebrated during Yule as well.
He lost.
So it's Christmas before Christmas. Mark's zoned out.
I drop Yule logs.
You do.
I will drop a Yule log.
So basically, it was Christmas before Christmas. I mean, basically, they're saying Christmas was based on Yule, which was, you know, way before Christmas. That's what they're saying. That's what Yule is. I mean, there's all kinds of things that's based on many traditions we use at Christmas time or borrowed from Yule traditions of old. So there you go. Happy Yule Day.
You'll be coming around the mountain.
It's actually longer than that, too. Today's the first day of it, but it goes until January 1st.
Oh, okay. Well, I never really cared about Yule. I like Christmas.
Start gaining more daylight at this point as
well. This is the shortest day of the year.
True. That's why.
Hey, interns, anything interesting going on in the comments section?
Wesley Lynch said that was the best looking elf he's ever seen.
Oh, he's talking about you.
I work with Wesley Lynch.
Oh, okay.
I love Wes.
All right.
Thank you, sir.
And Zach Hamilton, our new intern, the young
man.
Yes. He said that he will dye his hair when we hit 100,000 subscribers.
Okay.
So we're going to hold him to that.
100,000 subscribers on YouTube? That would be YouTube subscribers, yeah.
Right, yes, sir.
Well, that'll be
halfway there.
That'll be a minute. Yeah, we're halfway there, that's pretty much. All right. Cool. Well, listen, last episode, I gave Isaiah some homework.
Unfortunately.
I said, we need to do a segment with Isaiah. People love Isaiah. They love the way he sounds. They love his voice, his accent, his cute baby face, and his all-around demeanor. And so I said, well, let's give the people what they want. And we have a new segment with Isaiah where he basically he's going to review TV shows. And do we have an opening for that, the Alan Jackson? All right, here we go. Check it out. Redneck Reviews with Intern Isaiah, y'all. Maybe we're going to have you saying that at the end.
Y'all.
So, Isaiah, what did you review for us this time?
And just like that, it's a reboot of Sex. Well, not a reboot.
It's sort of like a continuation.
A continuation of Sex in the City.
Right. Okay. And you watched the first episode?
Yeah, I just watched the first episode.
Now, did you ever watch the original Sex and the City?
No, I never did watch the original.
Okay. So you know nothing about this going into it?
No, I didn't.
How old are you now?
20.
And how, I think it was 20 years probably when it came out.
Yeah, I think
so. You
it
were
came
like
out
zero
like
when it came out the first time.
Yeah.
Do you know exactly? I don't know the exact date.
I think it came out in like 96 or 97.
98.
When? What year were you born?
2001.
Yeah, okay. So you were three.
Yeah, I was
when
three.
This came out. All right. So I would love to hear your thoughts.
So, and just like that, I don't like the show.
Oh.
2 minutes in, and it's god-awful. So.
I watched it, too, and I kind of agree with you. It's silly. Go ahead. I'm sorry.
Yeah, it is very silly. So they're in like this restaurant, and I don't like the clothes they're wearing. It's just, it looks too uppity.
Yeah.
Like they need to dress like more plain and simple, blue jeans and a shirt. How about we go with that?
Yeah, yeah.
So I think, yeah, Charlotte, she was wearing this pink outfit, and to quote Darren McGavin from A Christmas Story, she looks like a pink nightmare.
You look like a pink nightmare. And take then, it off.
And then Carrie, she's wearing like a daggum basket on her head, like one of those like knitted baskets.
Yeah.
She's wearing it on her head.
Yeah. Well, they think they're little fashionistas. You know what I mean? That's New York. That's just how they do up there. But go ahead.
Yeah, I got that like right off the top. I'm like, they're into fashion. And
yeah.
It's awful. And then who's that one on the very left with the short hair?
Yeah. I forgot her name.
Miranda, that's her name. And she's wearing like, well, I don't know what the heck it was. It was like green and orange with like black stripes. So we're just going to call it unicorn vomit.
Okay. Unicorn vomit. All right. So you didn't like it.
No, I didn't like it.
What else you got?
And then so they're sitting in this restaurant eating. And it's like a high-end restaurant with like fancy food and stuff. And Carrie says, does anybody want to split the croque madame? What the hell is that? What's a croque madame? Can we just eat some simple food like biscuits and gravy and fried chicken?
Well, okay. I didn't know what a croque madame was either. I think it's just a sandwich with like a poached egg on it. Right.
Again, why can't... No. Okay, toad in a hole, frog in a hole. Yeah. Why can't we call it that? Why got to call it croque?
Because they think they're all uppity and fancy up there. That's why.
But why can't we simplify it? I mean, croque madame sounds like a French prostitute, not not the name of a dish.
It sounds like a French prostitute who just died. Madame croaked just now.
Yeah. Speaking of croque, what? Oh crap! How did the joke go? Anyway, I'll come back to it.
Okay. When you think of it, come back.
Yeah, I'll come back to
it. All right. What else you got, buddy?
We're 10 minutes in, and I already want to fast forward this 10 minutes of pure horse crap. I mean, it's awful.
Yeah.
So later on in the show, we're introduced to Carrie's husband, Mr. Big Man. And it's Mr. Big.
It's just Mr. Big. Yeah.
And he starts singing this Todd Rundgren song, whoever that is. I don't know who it is.
Oh, there you go. There's your fashion. That's what you were talking about. That does look like unicorn vomit. And, yes, so I watched this, too, because I wasn't going to make you do this alone. I watched this when I was in Lexington, Kentucky. And, it is kind of it's not our cup of tea. But go ahead. I didn't want to cut you off.
So who is, have you ever heard of Todd Rundgren?
Yeah, I've heard of him. Elliot, you know Todd Rundgren, right?
I don't believe so.
Oh, Mark Havaball.
I sure don't.
What? The two musical guys don't know Todd Rundgren?
If it came out after 1977, I have no clue.
Alan, help me. Come on.
Yeah, Todd Rundgren was big in the 70s and the 80s.
Oh, so yeah, dude. That's your wheelhouse right here.
Wait a minute. Actually, yes, he was. Yes, he was.
All right, go ahead. One of you, one of your fancy devices, Google Todd Rundgren.
You're right. He played the Fillmore soon after Tesla a couple years ago. Now I remember. He's a big producer.
So Mr. Big, was trying
to
serenade.
He's like serenading Carrie. You remember that, right? Mm-hmm. And he's serenading. And it's awful. Like, he can't sing worth a lick.
Right.
For a guy nicknamed Mr. Big, he sounds nothing like Eric Martin, who's the lead singer of Mr. Big.
Right.
So, flash forward about 36 minutes in, and this show is the drizzling turds. I mean, it sucks.
It's drizzling turds, yes.
Like, before that going into the 36 minutes, there's like nonsense about like masturbation, memes, and
that's
political
nonsense.
Correctness.
Well, yeah, they were doing one of the, was it Sarah Jessica Parker's character's name? What's her name? The character's name?
I forgot. It Carrie?
Carrie.
I think it's Carrie. Yeah, she was doing a podcast.
Yeah, she was doing a podcast
in this
episode, Bobby Lee.
With
and
Bobby
and
Lee.
Some
other
was it
lady.
A, yeah.
It was like a non-binary, non-gender.
She's like non-binary,
yeah.
Mexican.
So
and Irish.
It was a whole woke podcast. And it was kind of weird seeing Bobby Lee on it, sort of being not Bobby Lee so much.
Right. He's very woke.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
Correct.
He's not woke. But go ahead.
But yeah, so.
Yeah.
Well,
you were talking about
but
Mr. Big
anyway,
singing 36 Todd
minutes, yeah, right. 36 minutes in, everybody in the show is at like this boring piano recital, and Mr. Big Man decided to stay home and back on his little fancy Peloton bike,
yeah,
which is way too much work. Who wants to do that? The only time I ride a bike is when the hot and ready sign at Krispy Kreme flashes.
I would love to see you on a bike, biking to Krispy Kreme. I would love to see that. Do you have a bike?
No, I don't have a bike.
Go ahead.
So Charlotte's kid, I don't know what her name is, she gets up and starts playing the piano, and it's awful. I mean, it's the drizzling turds. And, well, she needs to learn how to play a cool instrument, like a piano, like a classical piano. It ain't cool. She needs to learn how to play like a banjo or a guitar.
Well, I mean, look, Isaiah, there's other instruments
and,
out there.
And she needs to learn how to play some Loretta Lynn while she's at it. None
well,
of this Mozart
be, yeah, sure.
BS.
They should probably learn that, but, you know, there's nothing wrong with a little classical music, but it's to each his own.
There's something
you.
Wrong with classical music. Learn how to play some Loretta Lynn, Patsy Cline.
All right.
Then we can, okay.
What else?
Anyway. So Mr. Big is biking, and he gets finished. He gets off the bike, and he clenches his heart and
yeah.
falls over. And then Carrie comes home from that piano recital that was a shit show. And she finds Mr. Big still holding his chest, and he's about to kick the bucket. He's about to croak. He's about to meet his maker, whatever adage you want to use.
That's fine. Those are good
and,
ones.
Instead of calling 911 like any normal person would do, she just starts like freaking out. Like,
yeah.
What? Help this poor feller out. Come on, woman. What the hell?
Right. That was a big point of contention on the show. Oh, by the way, spoiler alert, Mr. Big dies.
Yeah, spoiler alert. He's dead.
Yeah. He dies in the first episode.
Yeah, that's how the show ends, is he dies and she's just holding.
I think that's why they call it And Just Like That. The world changed like after he died.
Yeah, that's what she says at the end. And just yeah. like that, Mr. Big Man is
yeah.
dead.
Yeah. So let's see here. Who's one of your favorite wrestlers of all time?
Oh, Ric Flair.
And does Ric Flair have a signature move, figure four?
Yeah, figure four.
How many figure fours do you give this? That's the rating system.
Negative 3,000.
You got to go from one to five.
Five
figure fours. We'll go four figure fours. That's better. Four figure fours is the highest score you could have. Zero, obviously. So what are you going to give it?
Oh, zero.
Zero figure fours.
Yeah, zero figure fours.
Okay,
it's,
so look, Intern Isaiah,
terrible.
Not happy with it, just like that. Now listen, I still feel like you need to keep watching the season. That's
alrighty.
Like every week I want maybe a recap. We got to figure out what we're calling it. Right now we're calling it, what were we calling it? Redneck
Reviews
with Intern Isaiah. But if you don't like that name, if you have a better name, I just sort of, that's just placeholder for now. But thank you, Isaiah. That was very enlightening. Appreciate that. All right. We got money to give away. You hit the applause button. You did a good. Your segment's over. Good job, Isaiah. All right. Okay. We got money to give away, boys. I say we get to it. So this is the segment I was telling you about, Lexington. I've done some acting in my day. I've been in some sitcoms, I've been in some TV commercials, some movies, some adult films, but they have to pay you, and they're called residual checks. And what I'm going to do is open up one of these checks at random. I will let one of these two co-hosts hand me a check. I'll open it. I'll tell you what it's for, how it's airing. You call in. There should be a number up at the bottom of the screen. Start calling that number. The Alan Jackson will take three calls at random. We'll get you into the show. We'll talk to you a little bit. We'll see who has the best guess. Best guess wins the check. I sign it over to you and send it to you in the mail. It is a game. that we like to call. It's a game that we like to call.
How much is that Screen Actors Guild residual check?
All right. Okay. Well, Stamos, why don't you just slide one of these checks over to me and pick one at random. I got three sitting here. I'll open it down here where you can't see what it is. Because we're going to do some in-house guesses. I'm going to let these guys guess first, and then, well, you read my poker face at home at Novel, and then you let me know. You know, it'll help you with your guess. I hope you're starting to call in. You know, read my face after they guess. All right, here we go. Okay. All right. Dang, I forgot about this. Well, this is one check for an episode of Mad TV I did. Remember Mad TV?
Mad TV? I know you was on Mad TV.
One episode.
You've done everything.
This was one episode of Mad TV when the writer's strike was happening. There was a big writer's strike back in the early 2000s. And because of that, they weren't able to write sketches for Mad TV. So what they did was have comedians just come on and perform a set.
Ah.
So just me doing stand-up, but I did stand-up on Mad TV. And this is for pay TV, internet free, and video DVD, episode 1308 of Mad TV. I'll go with Stamos first, since you were here last. Stamos, how much?
Since it was a writer's strike.
It was a writer's strike, so they couldn't write. They had to have comedians come home.
So they couldn't have anybody write the check. Let's see. I'm going to go with the same number that I usually go with, $7.77.
Whoa, I was going higher than that.
But I don't know how they wrote the check. But.
That's not a bad guess.
Ooh.
Well, when I say writer's strike, I mean like writers who write jokes and sketches. Yeah, yeah.
Ironically, Mad TV was the longest running sketch comedy series on TV, with the exception of Saturday Night Live, to this day.
Oh, is that right?
Yeah.
I didn't know. Historian.
I believe it. Okay, Sebastian.
Well, I'm gonna go $8.15.
Okay. Copycat. Well, out of the you two, he's winning.
Oh.
Mm-hmm. Now let's go with.
He gave it away.
Well, just because the people at home, I want them to have good guesses when they call in. Isaiah, how much? Scratch, cash, check.
I'm going to go $7.95.
Okay. You're locked in.
$7.54.
Okay. Sergeant, have a ball.
I'm going to go $7.89.
Okay. Well, all those are decent. No one's right on it. But let's see how you fare. You start calling. The Alan Jackson, do we have people in the bullpen? Well, would you like to pick someone at random and let's get them in here and see if they can do any better than what these guys did? All right, Jon Reep here. Who am I talking to?
Danny Jackson.
Danny Jackson! Oh, hey, buddy! Hey. Guess what, dude? I got your envelope. We were going to do this at the end of the show, but now that you're on the air with me, check this out. He sent us this in the mail. Dude, you do great artwork. So here's a bandana. I'm loving this. Look at this. Ginger beard man. Orange bandana. Love that. Thank you, sir. Got your Christmas card right here. Did you fart in this? That's a no. I got your awesome stickers right here. Thank you for that. Yep. And we got this thing right here. We're going to put this on the fan art wall. See, right behind my interns is what I call the fan art wall. I call it the fan art wall because fan art is funnier than fan art. And we're going to have it. We'll pin it up behind one of these guys. Here you go, Stamos. Why don't you hand that to intern Isaiah, and maybe one of you guys could pin that up during the show. All right, Mr. Jackson. Appreciate all you do, buddy. I'm rooting for you. You deserve this check. I should just give it to you, but you got to guess, brother. Where you calling in from, by the way?
Peru, Indiana.
Wow.
Peru, Indiana.
Yeah. Do you know what that is, dude?
It's in Indiana, I guess.
Yes, yeah. Okay. What do you do besides make awesome artwork?
I'm a manager at the Dollar General in town.
Hell, the Dollar General?
Yes.
Oh, nice.
Yeah.
You guys ain't raised your prices yet, have you? You're not dollar buck and a quarter general, are you?
Some of it's more than that. Most of it, really.
Well, didn't they raise their prices?
That was a dollar tree.
That's what I'm saying, but like that's how it's going to start. Dollar General's next.
We have too, a lot of stuff.
We have what?
We have a lot of stuff.
Yeah. Okay. All right, Mr. Jackson.
Nasty.
Yeah.
Nasty.
Danny, if you're nasty. How much is the Screen Actors Guild residual, Jack?
I'm going to go with $5.55.
$5.65. Not bad. So far, you're winning because you're the first guess. There's two more guesses after you. but that's not bad. You're locked in. All right, put them on hold, the Alan Jackson. Let's go to the next random caller, see if they can do any better. Jon Reep here. Who am I talking to?
Hi, Gina.
Hey, Gina, how you doing?
I'm doing okay.
Where are you calling in from? Uh-oh.
We just lost Gina.
Gina, she hung up. I bet you she was at Novel.
Maybe Chuck E. Cheese.
She could have been at Chuck E. Cheese?
Or Novel.
What do you mean?
Sounds like a bunch of kids.
It sounds like there's some mayhem going on. All right, Gina, sorry we lost you. I wonder what she would have guessed.
Tell her to call back in, and if she calls back in, I'll try to put her back
in. Gina, call back in if you want to. If not, we're going to go ahead to the next caller, and if Gina comes back, we'll take her as the third caller. If not, we'll just go to the next person, right, the Alan Jackson? Jon Reep here. Who am I talking to?
You are straight off the Roanoke River in Dorsey Nethery.
What's your name?
Dorsey Nethery.
Dorsey Nethery from Roanoke Rapids.
Long time caller. Wait a minute.
Yes, sir. Ready to win another one.
Yeah.
Dorsey, going to Roanoke Rapids tomorrow, sir. Going there tomorrow.
Are you really?
Roanoke Rapids on the border.
What are you doing?
Working at a rest home.
Mm.
Trying to robbing them people up.
Hey, I hear you. How you been, Dorsey?
How about that? What, and now you're coming to work at the rest home? I mean, what kind of work are you doing?
We're getting their TV up, sort of.
No, plug your business while you're at
TV. We got to get them old people's TV up. Yeah. I like to watch the Showtime and Late Night Cinemax. Gets them crazy.
He has his own business where he installs, cable hookups and whatnots for people's. What's the name of your company?
Plug it.
Service Hub.
Service Hub. Look up Service Hub.
Two B's.
Two B's and Hub.
After my ex-wife, double B.
B's. That's not bad. All right. Dorsey, how you been, buddy?
I've been good. Been playing Santa Claus.
Oh, really? You got a big long beard?
Yes, sir. I got a fake one, yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, Dorsey,
yeah.
Why don't you give me your guess, brother? How much is this Screen Actors Guild residual?
I am going to say $6.51.
$6.51. Very good guess. Put them on hold, the Ellen Jackson. We got one more guess. And
I haven't seen Gina come back in, so.
Gina, we're sorry. Maybe next time, call in next week, because I got two more checks. We'll play next week if you'd like. All right, the Alan Jackson. Do we have anybody else?
Oh, yeah.
All right.
Next one's in.
All right, you're the last call. Who am I talking to?
I think it's Jake. Is this me?
You think you're Jake? You're not sure? Check your ID. What does it say on your driver's license?
Dang it, it's the same joke every time. I'm just kidding. To be honest with you, I have no idea what to guess. I'm going to throw in like $20.
Jake, where are you calling in from, my friend?
It's Pottsville, PA again. It's that guy that called himself the hillbilly last time.
Pottsville where?
PA, Pennsylvania.
Pennsylvania. Yeah. Cool. And what do you do for a living, buddy?
Personal care, home health care.
He's called in before, hasn't he?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, I have.
All right, well, what's your guess? You said $20, but I'm not going to let you do that. Give me a better guess than 20. Go lower than 20.
Lower? Oh, man.
They make numbers lower. Numbers lower.
We'll go $17.50. Oh. $17.50. I'll give right. you more than Stamos gave you.
Put him on hold. See, he's not paying attention. He's not watching or listening to the show in the bullpen. Because had he been watching or listening, he would have known better than to guess that. All right. But I'll appreciate everybody who calls. What I've done now is I've handed the check off to Sergeant Mark Havaball. That's right. We have a sergeant working as one of our interns here. And he's run the check into our producer, the Alan Jackson, who's going to crunch the numbers. And we're going to find out who won. The Alan Jackson, have you figured it out?
Yes, I have.
That was pretty quick, man.
Yes, I'm good.
All right, well, let's get the winner in here and see if we can get him to get exactly right.
All right, the winner is on the phone with you right
now. All right, who's this?
Yes, Dorsey.
Dorsey! What was your guess?
His guess was $6.51.
$6.51 was the best guess. You're close. You got the $6 part right. But you got to come up on the change a little bit. So, do you know anything about football and wide receivers?
Not really. Mm.
So I like to do football numbers. You know what I mean? So, this jersey number was one of the best Panthers receivers when Jake DeLong was the quarterback. One of you guys guess. Oh, no, I'm having some with you. Ooh, what was his jersey number?
Steve Smith was.
But that's not who I'm thinking of. But that's a good guess.
Musa Muhammad.
That's who I'm thinking of.
That's 81.
Was it 81? Oh, I thought it was 87. Oh, it was $6.87. It's 87. Okay. Well, congratulations, buddy. You're still going to get the check. And just so you know, I'm not lying to you. Here's the amount. I'll hold my finger next to it. $6.87. That's all you, big guy. And I have a question for you. What are you going to do with all that cash?
I'm going to save it because I got Jon Reep's autograph once again.
Oh, yes. Well, you're starting to collect. Yeah, what you call him, nerd?
His word.
Oh, nerd. You called him a nerd. All right, well, hand this over to I'll just keep it over here. I got to sign it anyway. All right, well, thanks, buddy. Congratulations. What you need to do now is go to countryish.com, click on the contact section, send me an email through that, give me your address. Once again, you got to start from scratch. Intern Elliot, the intern, will get it, and he'll send this out to you ASAP. Sound good?
Yes, sir.
Yep. All right.
Thank you for all you do, John.
Thanks, love buddy. Merry Christmas to you, brother. All right, listen, we got a lot more show to do. We're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back with more country-ish after this.
If you love this podcast and you love wearing shirts, well, we got something for you. If you go to countryishpodcast.com, click on merchandise, it'll take you to my store, and we have an awesome t-shirt for you. It's a Country-ish Podcast t-shirt. Look at it. Isn't it beautiful? Also, it's got the website on there. It's a soft tee, very soft, feels good on your skin, and it helps us keep the lights on here at the studio. So check out countryishpodcast.com, click on merchandise, get yourself a t-shirt, and know that I love you.
Hey there, are you a business owner? Do you have a product that you're trying to sell? Well, maybe I can help you. I've got over 350,000 followers across all my social media, and every episode of Country-ish we do gets thousands of views. So if you have a product that you want me to try on the show or to talk about, go to countryish.com, click on sponsorship, and maybe your stuff can be right here on my stuff.
Hey!
That thing got a hybrid?
Yeah.
Huge!
Come on! We're out of gas! Again?
Yeah, it's a hybrid. Sometimes you just gotta move on.
All right, we're back. I hope you hit the share button. If not, you can hit it anytime. Share away. Now, look, I also do another podcast with my good friend John Heffron. We do that Monday nights. It's called Heffron and Reap. And last week, we talked to Bo Duke. That's right. The John Schneider was on the show. And I want you to check out this little clip. If you didn't see it, here's what you missed last week. Check out this little clip of me and John Heffron on Heffron and Reap.
You have that awesome facility where you can shoot stuff on your thing. And you also do, and I had it pulled up, and I'm sorry, I lost it. You also do a bunch of Hallmark movies, which is a total thing. I wasn't into them, but then I had a box wine once, and now I get them. I have a Hallmark movie generator. I can type in any name, and it'll print out a plot. But here's what I think you could do. Right. Like I typed in, okay, John and his Meredith, a famous country singer. John set to marry a glamorous Hollywood actor returns to their small town roots when they cross paths with Meredith and their childhood sweetheart and blah, blah, blah. And they figure out if they love each other. Here's what you could do on your studio. You have a lot of couples come through. You should set up a little green screen, have a 2-line script, and let everybody be in a Hallmark movie. Everybody wants to have that one moment where the guy can look at his wife crying and goes, "You don't need to cry. I know when your nose twitches, you're sad. I know when the sun comes up, you immediately think of grandma." Like, you just have those moments and then you let people leave. I think there's something there. I think there's something there.
I think that's a great, I can't call it Hallmark though. I have to call it John Mark.
Yeah,
yeah, just a John Mark. Perfect.
That's a great idea. It could be scored like, you know.
Scored. Just like a personalized. It could
be scored like that.
And you have actors, or you just have them. Everybody wants to be in that scene, and they play it all the time.
You're right. I think that's a great idea.
So there you go. That's yours.
Have them jump the General Lee. Woo!
Yeah, 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 exactly. So
we could do that too. I think that's a great idea.
John Heffron is full.
Lee, I'm going to do the General Lee one.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh, yeah. John Schneider and Heffron. Yeah, you can check out Heffron and Reap every Monday night right here on this page. Or go to heffronandreap.com and check it out. All right, let's move on to the next segment. You know, there's a lot of negative things going on in the news. There's a lot of politics and pandemics and whatnot. And we don't like to talk about that so much. We like to talk about weird, funny, happy-go-lucky things that fall through the cracks. I think my friend Justin Clyde Williams could tell you better. I'll let him tell you.
We're just small town dudes with small town news, breaking stories of crimes committed you never do. Mind your P's and Q's or they'll cover you. The town may be small, but the news is huge.
Alrighty, boys. Well, this happened up there in Canada, eh? You ever been up there in Canada?
Aye.
Yeah, British Columbia. You ever been up there?
Nope.
Yeah, well, it's cold. They got lots of wildlife, and they also celebrate Christmas, huh? And this happened up there. A family's Rudolph decoration was repeatedly attacked by a real deer. So this real deer saw, like, a Rudolph in the front yard and went after it. Yeah, you used to laugh and call him names. Now they're assaulting him. That's horrible. A British Columbia woman said the red-nosed Rudolph decoration has been an irresistible target for an aggressive local deer despite its glowing snout. So I wonder which one it was. Can you name
Dancer? Dancer?
All right, hang on. Dancer?
Prancer?
Prancer?
Donner?
Donner?
Blitzen?
Blitzen?
No, it's not Vixen. Blitzen. It's Vixen.
Vixen. Yep, Vixen's a good one.
Cupid? Comet?
No, Comet, yep.
Trixie?
Prance, you're just missing. You're missing Dasher. That was
damn Dasher. That's the one you wanted.
I think it's Blitzen. Blitzen sounds like a name that he's blitzing the quarterback. Yeah. He sounds like an aggressive person.
They've all always picked on Rudolph.
Well, this person's name is, they don't like to play the games. Arlene of Fort Nelson said her family first repurposed the 3D archery target. So it was an archery target, this thing that they made, which is the size and shape of a real white-tailed deer, into Rudolph the red-nosed white-tailed deer. About 5 years ago they did this, and they quickly discovered local deer apparently couldn't tell the difference. And she shared a video of this on her Facebook page, and we have a video. Let's check out the video. Let's watch this. Okay, here we go. So you got Rudolph sitting there. It's a buck. He's got his antlers. Uh-huh. Oh, he sees that red nose. He's thinking, I'd like to give me some of that. Oh, got a little nervous. He's walking up. He's checking it out.
Looks like you're in your game, Stamos.
Yeah, you see his buddies over there watching too.
He's trying to support you. Oh, down. And he's out. Oh, it was a quick attack. That was like a Smollett thing. He just went in, smashed him, and smash and grab. He just hit him and hit and run. Every year, a buck in the area attacks this thing or hits it, knocks it over, and breaks him. You want to play reindeer games, huh? You'll go down, all right. Not in history. You're just going to go down in the snow, Mr. Rudolph. She said she was surprised that the deer weren't warded off by the glowing red bulb that her husband installed on Rudolph's nose. I'm like, he has a bright red nose, she said. I'm not sure what they really see. I don't know. So what do you think it is about this deer that's attracting? Because this has happened many times.
Well, I think the buck stops here, definitely.
That's right. Okay.
Thank you, Robert. Thank you.
Stamos, what are your thoughts?
I think so. The buck definitely think that's a female deer.
Oh, why was he?
He's just flirting.
No, that's not flirting. That may be some of the stuff you do. That's your game, and you knock him down like that.
I think he's challenging him. I mean, that's not how you flirt. You don't like attack him with your antlers, do you?
He wasn't getting the respect he thought.
That's right. Like the head wasn't moving. Well, that something scared him right there. Yeah. Maybe the owner's putting deer piss all over it. You know how they use deer piss to attract other deers?
That's a Tom Brady deer, a buccaneer.
yeah, just going in for the
got him.
The attack. And
so this happens every year.
He ran away.
I feel like that, if you were to hunt deer, I don't hunt deer, but is this something that you would shoot and eat?
This is a buck, yeah. This is the prize.
So, I mean, this is a good way to get deer.
Yeah, all these people putting all this corn out every year and all this
fake deer. Place,
just put Rudolph
out. Put Rudolph out there. Bright shiny nose. All right. Well, she theorizes the bucks who are in their rutting season might not be paying attention to Rudolph's features beyond the decoration antlers. She said her family plans to continue to repair and display Rudolph despite the repeated attacks. He's still standing proud.
Isn't this what gets us all in trouble as a nice rat?
Yeah. Well, Merry Christmas up there, Rudolph. So look, ladies and gentlemen, if you don't get your presents on time, it's Rudolph. He's hurt. You know, it's not COVID. He got attacked. He's down by some angry buck. All right, let's move on, guys. Oh, thank you, Justin Clyde.
The town may be small, but the news is huge.
All right, this is my favorite part of this episode. It is Christmas up in here today. Well, when this comes out, it might be Christmas. It is the season, guys. And we're going to play Secret Santa. And we've all drawn names. And we all have gifts next to us. I don't know. Only Alan Jackson knows whose Secret Santa is who. And we have gifts next to us. And do we just open them and try to guess who got us the gift? What do you think we should do?
Yeah, let's go. Let's go around. Whoever wants to go first, you can open the gift and try to guess who you think might have bought it for you.
All right.
From the other people.
You go first, John.
Well, also, I'll go first, but also I got my Moose mug from National Lampoon's Christmas Vacation, and my man Sergeant Haveball. By gosh, if he hasn't already made some eggnog, thank you, buddy.
When you got me in a corner. I was bored. I had to do something.
Won't you hook me up with some eggnog? Put it in my moose glass. And everybody have some eggnog. I got this eggnog today. And what do you think? We got cinnamon sticks. We got nutmeg. and I accidentally grabbed some paprika. Now, I don't think you're supposed to put... Yeah, it was an accident. It looked the same color as nutmeg.
Paprika?
Paprika. Paprika? Paprika. I say paprika.
Paprika.
Paprika?
Yeah, paprika.
Paprika. Paprika. Yeah. Anyway, don't put that in there. Just do the eggnog. And who all wants some eggnog? Stamos, I think you should try it. I know you're not a big sweet guy.
I'll put my lips up.
I want you to try it just so everybody can see your reaction. How does Stamos react to eggnog? That's what they want to see.
How sweet is eggnog?
I haven't had eggnog in 10 years probably. So I don't even remember. Oh, that's a mess. Look at that. All right. Merry Christmas, everybody. I'll wait till y'all get yours. Look, that's my little cinnamon stick. And that's nutmeg.
It's not coming off his nose.
Yeah, he's a little messy. All right, you get some, you get some. Now, listen, guys, I'm going to be honest with you. I got this at the ABC store. Mm. This has liquor in it. This is Evan Williams eggnog, which means, Isaiah, you can't have any. You're not 21.
You shouldn't have told anybody.
Well, I have to because Elliot is also a recovering alcoholic, and he can't have any. So that means it's just us. And have them all. Of course, you can have some.
We haven't recovered
and,
yet.
The Alan Jacks. No, no. We hadn't hit rock bottom yet. So here.
Feliz Navidad. Cheers.
Feliz Navidad. Prost. Merry Christmas. Happy Halloween. Mmm.
That's not bad. What do you think about the reaction on something? It's not bad, is it?
It's good.
Honestly, that's really good. It's sweet. It's sweet, though, so you can't do it. Wow. All right. So I'll go first. My gift is right here. I don't know who got this because it's a secret. It's Secret Santa, but I'm going to go ahead and open it. Oh, what's the chatter, boys? Huh?
Nothing.
No side talking.
No clicks.
No clicking. Jolly Jules Ball Wash.
Ooh, that's a good one.
All right, it's ballsy. Jolly Jules Ball Wash. Bourbon and Barrel makes this. Well, I'm assuming this is for me to wash my balls with. It's probably some sort of body wash. But I'm going to guess that this was from Isaiah.
Yeah, you're correct.
That's a good one, Isaiah.
Just like Isaiah, because your shirt says balls on it, yeah, right? What does your shirt say?
It says check out my balls.
You are sort of fascinated by balls. You love balls.
I'm kind of jealous, though, because I'm the only ball in the room.
That's right. His last name is Ball. You should be all over this ball.
I drew his name.
Yeah, we didn't get him right.
Yeah, we did.
That's what we were talking about.
What?
It's for him. There's a big mix-up.
Oh,
like, we got a big...
So this is for him?
Yeah.
He's already opened his.
Wait a second.
You said I have the text.
That's okay.
As proof.
So does that mean that you're... You have to get up.
Let me see.
So this is yours now.
Okay.
Ball wash. That makes sense. That makes sense. Yeah. And is that from you, though?
Yeah, that's
And you
from
had
me.
His name.
Yeah, okay. I drew his
so
name.
So I'm going to open this one.
But it's you is don't know this, who it's from.
That, all right, so let's just be honest. Who's this? Who got this one?
Me.
All right, who's it for?
You.
Is it supposed to be for me?
Yeah.
Then we're back on track. All right.
Nice
like
air
your
bubbles.
Tissue paper.
Nice air bubbles.
Yeah.
Tissue. Didn't have tissue paper.
Oh, here we go. Now, did you get this at a Goodwill?
Got at a Goodwill. We
so this
to
is
Goodwill.
The Goodwill Hunting edition of Secret Santa. We,
here we go.
Wow.
What does it say?
Pretty thick.
Oh, dude.
They had that at Goodwill.
What does it say?
I love gingers.
Oh. Yeah.
No, that's
I did.
Great.
Look, there's the price tag's on the top of it there. Goodwill thing.
It's an extra large.
But I think it's been dried a little bit. It's a little small.
Okay. Well,
extra large.
That's very appropriate. I am a ginger, though. So that's like me saying I love myself.
Yeah.
But it's fine. I am. I do love myself. Yeah. Everyone should love themselves. I agree.
Nothing more fitting.
Thank you, and Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Who wants to go next? Who's next?
Sean's next.
Sebastian?
Oh, I'm next.
Yours is right there.
Well, I got two, boys.
Two. And they're finally wrapped.
Do you know who got it for you?
I have no idea.
You have to open it and guess.
I have no idea. Whoever can wrap... Probably Alan Jackson. Or Alan's not
Alan
in here, sorry.
Play.
Okay.
Oh, a flask.
Oh, flask. Why would anybody buy me a flask?
Goodwill. This has to be from Goodwill. I'm hoping they got it from Goodwill.
Yeah.
It says Canadian Club. Does that say reserve or pervert? Yeah.
Reserve.
Yeah, preservatives.
Thank you.
Reserve, yeah. Oh, so this is Canadian Club flask.
I'm almost going to say this is probably Elliot. Am I wrong, Elliot?
I can neither confirm nor deny.
Elliot puts a card with everything.
Right.
Your secret elf.
Oh,
that's...
Has to be Elliot. Am I wrong?
And he got two gifts. Not wrong.
Right.
Let me open the other one, Elliot.
Look, I also love that you crammed it in this box right here. Look, you chipped away at it.
I modified it, yes.
Yeah, so to make it work.
Stash his flask in there. Yes, sir.
That's perfect.
Yep.
Did you get this box at Goodwill, too?
I did.
Oh, wow.
Elliot, you don't know what I've crammed in boxes before.
Oh, look. You live it. You have a place in Florida.
I love there. You, Beach.
I love you, Beach.
That's for Bette Midler.
Yes. Perfect, wow. Elliot. Perfect. Thank you, sir. I'm actually going to hang that up.
Yeah, you can put that in your Florida home.
Yes. This is fantastic.
Wow. Good job.
I love a good beach. Love a good beach.
Total retail price, $10. I think our limit was 10 bucks. 10.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. Good job. Are you happy?
That's fantastic. That's the best thing. All right.
But is that a party foul? Is the flask full or empty?
Oh.
That's for your eggnog.
I'll put my eggnog in and take it home.
Okay, so it's going to be empty because you can't put anything in there. Okay. Stamos.
I'm next.
Yeah, let's see what you got.
What does it say?
Boxers or briefs? It's a game.
$6. $6 for this.
Let me see I'll read it. So this is off-the-wall humor, side-splitting fun. Grab some friends and get ready for rounds of laughter as each player is put in the hot seat. The hilarity begins when you have to choose from the wild and wacky statements your friends pick to describe you. Will they reveal hidden quirks? Or will you all share a good laugh at their absurd choices? There you go.
Sticking to mud.
That sounds like a fun game we could play here.
Yeah. We could do that.
Thank you.
Who done it? Who gave it to you, you think?
Who's it from?
Who's it from?
This guy.
Mm-hmm. Mark Ball.
I seem to remember that we actually got pretty well involved to figure out those boxes or briefs about 3 weeks ago.
Oh, yeah. Coming up maybe next episode, we took some sexy pictures for the focus. We're trying to be page 3 girls. And so we all seen each other in our skivvies, and maybe next week you'll see what we did, right, the Yellow Jackson?
Correct.
Okay.
Oh, I see now. I get it.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mark.
Boxers or briefs?
Yes.
There you
Good
go.
Good one.
All right, let's go with Elliot. I did it because you was reaching for it.
I figured where it's going.
I know. Okay, then Elliot, hold up.
You pulled the swerve.
Isaiah, you want to go?
You go. It don't matter.
Let's do Elliot last.
Yeah, let's go. Let's do Elliot last.
No.
Yeah, those are virtual reality goggles, it looks like. Wow. That's all the rage. Those Oculus, dude.
Yeah.
Can't believe they had those Oculuses at a Goodwill.
Is that like a new Viewmaster?
Yeah. Well, there's probably three things in there.
And then liquid plant food. What?
Well, I think that fell out of a box.
Yes,
it's like
a pod kit.
Yeah. So I know you like that. Okay, that's for me. I'm just going to fess up. I know you like to grow stuff. I know you're like a little green thumb. You got a garden at your house. I've been there.
Yeah, well, I have a garden.
Yeah, and so I thought, like, well, this would be good for you. You like to grow stuff. You could have your own little seed pods. You know what
Thank
I'm saying?
You.
Yeah, and there's more.
There's more.
So that's,
Wait,
there's
that's
three
not
things.
All.
There's more.
Yeah, you got virtual reality goggles.
Bought all this for $10?
Yep. It actually was $11 and something.
And a tiger.
What high school did you go to?
Fred T. Ford.
What's her mascot?
Tigers.
Boom.
Do you know what the T stands for in Fred T. Ford?
Theodore.
No, it's a...
Tiger.
Am I... Is it Theo... It's Theo something.
I don't know.
You acted
know
like
I'm
you
like?
Knew.
Anybody?
Yeah, I thought you knew. You were going
to
tell
well,
me.
Well, I'm pretty sure it's Theo, but I need...
I don't
what does
know.
That have to do with anything?
Ball, why don't you Google that? Look up Fred T. Ford. What's the T stand for? All right, there you go. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas, Isaiah.
Merry
I hope
Christmas.
You enjoy your seed pods, your virtual reality goggles, and your tiger.
Thank you.
And you're absolutely certain that has nothing to do with his love for Tiger King.
Oh, he also
I've
loves Tiger King.
I've never seen Tiger King.
Oh, he doesn't love Tiger. See, that makes sense.
with you.
Yeah.
Oh, another thing for me to review.
No, I need you to watch stuff that you don't want to watch.
Well, I don't want to watch Tiger King, so.
No, but you will once you start it.
Yeah.
Trust me. All right, go ahead, Elliot. What's your gift?
Real quick, while he's opening it.
Yeah.
I'm going to butcher the hell out of this. Theophilopsis?
Is it Theodopoulos?
No, it's Theo, P-H-E-O-L-U-S.
Oh, the P-H probably with an F sound. Yeah,
Theophilopsis. So I was right. Theophilopsis?
Thanks for bringing that up.
All right. Interesting. He was, do you know what Fred T. Ford did? He was like a landowner, right? A farmer or something?
I have no idea.
All right. Elliot, what's your gift?
I don't know. I had to saw into it.
Fred Ford was actually a doctor.
Oh, he was a doctor.
Yes, sir.
I was way off. I said farmer. Hey, guys. Thanks for watching the podcast. I hope you're having a great Christmas. My one of my interns is having a hard time getting into his Christmas gift. He'll get that, actually. You look like a young Santa Claus before his beard turned gray.
Thank you very much.
You're like from that Rankin Bass movie.
Right.
Okay, now just remember, we do have sponsors, right? Current and hopefully in the future. Right.
Yeah, okay, I don't know. So I don't know what this gift is. Yeah. I did not get you this gift. I don't know what this is. I don't know who it is from.
What did you do?
Oh. I don't know what it is, but I do know that he's very proud of something. Let's go. Open a gift.
Oh. Wait, yeah.
He's scared.
It's bat soap. Yeah, it's
bat soap. Okay.
Hey, look, I got.
Why is
I
he
got
not? What's he hesitant about?
Well, I think these go together.
Read it.
I'm not going to read it. You read it. Yes.
The original wiener cleaner soap.
Wiener cleaner soap.
It's that gift that keeps on giving.
Oh, what a brilliant idea. So wait, hold it up.
No, I had it.
So it's a ring of soap. What a genius idea. How come they... I would like a wiener ring soap.
Yeah.
You didn't get that at a Goodwill.
I mean, that's a little bit small for me.
Yeah.
Now, who got this for Elliot? There's no way you got this at a Goodwill.
At the Goodwill in Florida.
Oh, Goodwill in Florida has, of course, Florida has wiener ring soap. Yeah. You going to use it, buddy?
Probably not.
I mean, you know, what scent is it? It's orange. Is it like a ginger?
I don't know if it's been opened, Elliot. I taped it.
Is that the only
together.
Thing in there? Is it just that? That's awesome. Okay, yeah. Let me throw it over here. I want to see it. Oh, he's taking it out.
Yeah, it's wrapped.
Oh, it's still wrapped. It's all good.
I want to know what it smells like. All right, I need one of y'all to go to the bathroom and try this thing out.
It doesn't really have like a, it just smells like soap. Like
it's not an onion ring. You're not going to eat it. Okay, it looks, that's genius, though.
Well, you're welcome.
I've never heard of that before. I feel
like
that should be
a
thing.
Well, here's why I Googled it after I got it. It said it cleans the body but dirties the mind.
Boom. There you go.
You'll be showering twice a day with your new bath toy.
It's an awful big hole.
Well, no, I think
yourself,
it's...
Stamos.
What do you mean that's a big hole?
Look at it.
Yeah, I'm looking right at it. That's big for you? You wouldn't touch the size?
No, I would not.
Wow, that's weird, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
You must have a little wiener or something.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night. All right, listen, I think we should end this episode because everyone loves Isaiah's voice. Isaiah, would you read to us the night before Christmas?
Yes,
I
will.
And be sincere about it.
But let me look it up first because my laptop died like 2 seconds ago. I
swear you don't have a charger? You don't have a charger, do you? It's okay. While he's doing that, look it up. And while he's doing that, I'll remind you all to rate, review, subscribe, and share. Hope you had a good time. You know, this is our Christmas episode. We're having a ball in here, literally. And we
all
and hope you had a good time. Tell others. If you want to help the podcast out, you can go to countryish.com. You can become a Patreon supporter. You can write us a nice review on Apple Podcasts. And really, just sharing this is really one of the biggest things you could do if you want to help us out. I'll be on the road. I'm home for Christmas. Love it. And then my next gig will be in, I'm looking at
San
Isaiah.
Diego.
San Diego. Are you ready, buddy? You got it?
Yeah, I got it.
All right. Why don't you, this is how we'll end this podcast. We'll have Isaiah read us Night Before Christmas.
You want me to read the whole thing? Because it's kind of lengthy.
Well, remember when I asked you in the beginning, is it long?
Well, I found one that was long, and then I found one that was like real short. But it wasn't like
first
the full.
Stanza.
Yeah, read. First stanza. Just start reading, and then Alan, when I point to you, that means just end the show. Just start
well, should
reading.
I hit the applause button first, or do you just want me to
hand me the thing, and I'll hit the applause button. That's when everyone will know that I'm done with you. Okay, thank you. Go ahead and start reading, buddy. The night before Christmas.
It was the night before Christmas when all through the house, not a creature was stirring, not even a mouse. The stockings were hung by the chimney with care in hopes that St. Nicholas soon would be there. The children were nestled all snug in their beds while visions of sugar plums danced in their heads. Mm. And Mama in her kerchief and I in my cap had just settled our brains for a long winter's nap. When out of the lawn there arose such a clatter, I sprang from my bed to see what was the matter.
Thank you. All right, everybody. Appreciate you watching. We'll see you next week. Bicycle!
Well, life on the farm is kind of laid back, but I wouldn't know that I'm from a cul-de-sac. Don't chew tobacco and I don't smoke crack. Thank God I'm country-ish. Well, a simple kind of life, every dip and no harm, but I do know a guy with only one arm. Keep your fancy smartphones and yourself parked cars. Thank God I'm country-ish.
Well, I got a podcast that'll make you giggle. It ain't number one, it's right in the middle.
The town's not big, but it ain't too little. It's time for country-ish.
Hey everybody, it's me again. I just want to say thank you for listening or watching this podcast. You know, we couldn't do this without supporters like you. Oh wait, are you not a supporter? Well, you could be. It's real simple. Go to countryishpodcast.com. Click on the word support. That will take you to our Patreon page. That's our support page. And from there, you can support us many different ways. There's different levels. You got $5 and up. You got Pewter Pro, Rhinestone level, Executive Zirconia, all the way up to Platinum Elite. And all of them come with different rewards. We're talking hats, t-shirts, ginger beard masks, even be a guest on the show. You got to check out our Patreon page. Go to countryishpodcast.com, click on support, and thank you. Oh. Go ahead, continue.
Alrighty. But I heard him exclaim ere he drove out of sight, Merry Christmas to all, and to all a good night.